down in the upper part of begonia.
And we'd have great prices on begonias.
Great plants, great prices. Always at Walmart.
Walmart makes it possible for us to have a yard we can be proud of.
What a nice thing to say.
In the next half hour, Weather Center, a comprehensive national forecast. At 40 after, Weather Center continues with highway and air travel conditions. Then the weekend outlook. And at 50 after, Storm Watch. But right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel. Covered much of the southeast Thursday, moves northward. Some major cities along the east coast will have a soggy Friday night. We'll have that story and your forecast for the first weekend in May next on Weather Center.
Indeed, we have started the first weekend in, can you believe it's May already?
I can't.
It is amazing. This year is going by very quickly. Mm-hmm. And we have some rain and maybe some big thunderstorms to deal with as we head on into the second day of May. Good evening. Welcome to this edition of Weather Center. I'm Jeff Morrow.
And I'm Kim Perez. We'll also be taking a look at the west and a few showers out there. Plus, we'll be also talking about the pattern in April and why we had so much severe weather across the southeast, as well as your forecast. But let's concentrate on the heavy rainfall that moved through the northeast and still moving through the northeast. And Philadelphia, just one of the big cities tonight that was hit hard with heavy rainfall. And if you only had one umbrella between all of you, you were definitely sharing it today. And if you didn't have an umbrella, you were using the old jacket. Around D.C., same idea. Anything you could find to cover your head was a good idea. The rain tapering off somewhat around D.C. right now. Most of the heavy rain moving away from the area. And actually, tomorrow should be a little bit better out there for you. Now, in Manhattan. Well, a lot of folks probably hitting the subways today or the taxis. Not a great day to be out walking to work. But definitely prepared. Most of the folks did have umbrellas out there tonight. Heavy rain still moving through Manhattan. Temperatures, in the upper 50s or so. And actually, tomorrow, even into Manhattan, we should have some better weather out there. Well, you notice here on our satellite picture, this dry area coming in right here. Kind of like a dry slot. This will be working into the coastal areas tonight and tomorrow after this heavy rain moves out. So you're going to look at some better weather here in Manhattan and Brooklyn and also in Queens, farther south even into New Jersey where we saw some heavy rain tonight. But off to the west, we do have that upper level low. And this upper level low is not going anywhere fast. So underneath this upper level low, expect a few clouds out there and even a few showers to persist over the next few days until we can get rid of this low. Now our front moving through Virginia and the Carolinas tonight, we've seen some severe weather with this. No active warnings at this point. Most of the warnings have expired, but it's been right around our low and our warm front here that we did see the severe weather tonight, a really good convergent area where we have dew points in the 60s, a lot of added lift in there, and we saw some pretty big cells develop and even some large hail, golf ball size hail, not just here ahead of our front, but actually here just off to the west underneath that upper level low around St. Louis getting hit hard with some hail tonight. That threat is pretty much over with. The Ohio Valley, a few showers out there tonight and heavy rainfall earlier. In southeast Ohio, we had gale warnings, flash flood warnings out for Galea County. That has expired though. But in the Northeast, especially in the New England, expect the heavy rain to move northward. So if you live in Boston, or if you live anywhere points west, or even into Albany, this heavy rain is rotating your way. How much rain have we seen so far? Check this out. Well, into Jersey, we've seen over an inch to 2 inches in some cases, the same in West Virginia and even into Ohio, and even as far north and west as into southeastern Michigan. Some of that heavy rain still coming in from the east. Kind of unusual to see the rain moving in this way. And again, around New York, expect conditions to improve here once we get rid of this area right here. It's better weather for sure here. Where we see that severe weather, though, is farther south, where we did see it earlier tonight. Well, it doesn't look as impressive now as it did earlier, but there are still a few cells out there. Folks in Norfolk should still be keeping an eye out for this, and even in Richmond tonight. Florida looking a lot better here. Actually, most of the activity has pretty much ended. A few showers out there this evening, and that's about it. Now for a look at the rest of the country, here's Jeff.
All right, Kim, and the West Coast also had to deal with a little bit of rain and a little bit of thunder action as we headed through late this afternoon and on into early this evening. Big storm spinning just offshore, and that's going to be with us probably right on into the early part of next week. Let's go ahead and take a look at a satellite radar composite. And again, I have to apologize for the little black hole there at the bottom left-hand corner. A little bit of a satellite glitch comes and goes. But there you can see it pretty nicely, our spinning storm here. And if I put my finger right there, it actually looks like it's moving west, doesn't it? It may kind of, that's called retrograding. It may actually spin around out here for a little bit before it finally comes inland. Probably Monday or Tuesday of next week, we'll have to wait. But in the meantime, around this system, we'll be rotating some bands of moisture. One of those bands moved into Northern California today with some rain. Thunderstorm action, mainly where we got a lot of sunshine early today and it really destabilized the atmosphere. Then you got maybe a disturbance rotating around that upper level low, and again, still thunder and lightning going on all the way from, well, coastal southwest Washington back up through the Columbia Gorge. Not too much in the way of rain around San Francisco now, but there was some rain earlier in the day. Unlike a lot of the rain that Kim was just showing you back east, though, the rain in San Francisco was pretty much on the light side. And again, you can see that the windshield wipers were going, the umbrellas were out, but nothing more than maybe a few hundredths of an inch to it, maybe a tenth of an inch or so was the most we saw from this. That band of rain has now moved generally to the east of San Francisco, but even that is starting to fall apart a bit. And again, still some thunder and lightning kind of comes and goes here, the radar imagery coming and going, but there's still some embedded thunder and lightning in here. And there have been some reports of a few trees down earlier and perhaps even some power outages. That's what's going on in the far west.